UnityPoint Health St. Luke's Hospital Heart and Vascular Institute takes you inside the heart for an atrial septal defect repair, also referred to as an ASD. Our patient is Lisa Kirchhoff of Independence. She's a patient of Dr. George Hodge, a cardiologist from UnityPoint Health Cedar Rapids Cardiology Clinic.
The way we diagnosed this defect in this patient was through a heart check. The heart check was performed as a screening check for multiple things.
I decided to do the heart check just because I thought it'd be great to get a clean bill of health, get that done. Went in and was shocked to discover that I had a congenital heart defect. So I had no symptoms at all.
So on the ultrasound of the heart, we noticed enlargement of the right side of the heart. And this is typically what happens when there is an ASD left untreated with significant shunting of the blood from one side to another. And many patients may not have symptoms. If the patient doesn't have any symptoms, but there is enlargement of the right side of the heart, it is strongly recommended to close the hole. If the patient has symptoms, then definitely the hole should be closed. The patient had an abnormal connection between the top two chambers of the heart. This is a congenital heart problem. And the procedure consisted of closing this abnormal connection or an abnormal hole between the two top chambers of the heart.
Why, in the back of my head, I kept thinking, this can't be right, because I run, I bike, I lift weights, I take the stairs at work, I take like six, a couple times a day I'll take six flights of stairs. I was never out of breath, because I was reading about all the symptoms. I'm like, oh, people that have this can't exercise and they can't catch their breath and, they're so tired all the time. And I remember thinking, this is not me, this cannot be right. But now that I have it done, it almost feels like I must have been taking deep breaths to fill my lungs. Because right now, if I just breathe normal, it feels like my lungs are filling with air. And before, it was almost like every once in a while I had to really feel it. And now it's like, yeah, this is what it feels like to breathe normal.
Left untreated, yes, it can cause right-sided failure of the heart, called right-sided congestive heart failure, because the right side of the heart will be suffering for a long period of time from high pressure setting due to the amount of shunting of the blood from the left to the right. Significantly worse enlargement of the chambers of the heart can develop. And when that happens, that can cause significant swelling of the legs, shortness of breath. It can increase the pressure in the lung arteries because the lung artery goes from the right heart to the lungs. And so increasing the pressure in the right side of the heart will also lead to an increased pressure in the lung arteries called pulmonary hypertension. So right failure, right-sided failure is the result of untreated ASDs for a long period of time.
Dr. Hodge said, I could have went another 10 or even 20 years without symptoms. By then, there would have been damage to my heart and lungs, and, that's something you can't get back. Yeah, he said I definitely could start working out, and I asked him, I said, does that mean I'll be a faster runner now? Because, I was always sort of plodding along. Maybe it was because I couldn't breathe. Maybe I'll be able to run a marathon now. Who knows? So I just think any sort of preventative thing you can do, as long as tests, even if you think you're in great health and you're eating right and you're exercising, and it never hurts to check.
We invite you to learn more about UnityPoint Health St. Luke's Hospital Heart and Vascular Institute and how to prevent heart disease.